But I'd like to talk to you about the president's press conference post midterm elections. Now, at the outset, I want to make it abundantly and inarguably clear I'm not a Trump supporter, but I am a supporter of truth. I voted against Trump. I voted for Hillary Clinton, although I didn't want to. What the Democrats did to Bernie Sanders was a disgrace. And so, knowing that Donald Trump was not qualified for the job and a danger, to the possible office of the presidency, I voted against him. I fight him and the Republicans who support him on social media. I've been doing this for 2 years, so no one should misunderstand this as support for Trump morally or politically. But what I do like to talk about as a philosopher is truth. And truth is often a victim in all types of discourse, personal and public, with friend and foe. And so the people I would ordinarily agree with, I need to call out, and I need to say, be careful of what you're doing. I don't do a lot of research. I do a lot of reading, and I do pay attention to a lot of videos and podcasts and discussions and lectures. I don't think it's necessary to come in here and try to pretend to be a journalist. So I'm not going to name any names of the journalists whom I mentioned. You'll know who they are. I will name the more obvious people and in the more obvious cases. I thought what Jim Acosta did was great, and I think that's what journalists have to do, and journalists should be doing more of that rather than going on long broadcast tirades about how bad the president is. We know how bad the president is. Stick to the facts. Keep nailing those to the wall. Keep posting bills about that. Keep broadcasting about that. Your opinions are appreciated in the minimum, not the maximum. The opinion area is for the citizenry. The journalists are supposed to be stating the facts. So, there was an African American journalist from CNN whose name I don't recall. I'm on her side. However, I actually want to give her credit because she wouldn't take the bait that was coming from Wolf Blitzer, where he kept saying, "Do you think that the president was right in calling your question racist?" She stayed to what she thought was true, and that was that the president was angry. And this is what I want to say. He was angry, he was unhinged, he was acting like a regular Joe who was being attacked. Because that's what he is. Americans have to take responsibility for the fact that they still allow their elections and their PACs and their political parties to be predicated on private money. This is an egregious, woefully stupid misdeed. Okay? It's not a mistake because it's deliberately done year after year. Americans do not opt to have their elections paid for by taxes, which is what they should do, which is what is morally and intelligently right to do. As long as you keep your elections paid for by private money, you will have gross, astronomical amounts of corruption, and you will have people in office who don't belong there. Now, that said, this journalist stuck to the point of saying that the president was angry and he was upset because he actually thinks that her question, in his mind, is a quote-unquote racist question. And this brings up my next point. I've been talking for 5 years about how intellectuals and journalists and statesmen and women should not be using the word race or its derivatives. It is a misnomer, and if you look into the science, you will realize that it's not legitimate to be calling the differences between people racial in nature. The only differences we have are philosophical, cultural, religious, and cognitive. We don't have any substantive racial differences. We're all the same subspecies, we're all the same species, and we're all the same genus. There is one human race on the planet. So, using the word race because you think that it gives credit to the fight against prejudice is stupid. The only thing that makes sense in the fight against prejudice is fighting prejudice. And prejudice is always ethnic and cultural, it is never racial. No matter how much people want to be racists, no matter how much they want to pretend that there are races for the point of their argument or for their agenda. It's not sensible, it's not helpful. In fact, when you use the word race, you give credence to the people who think there are different races among humans. There are not. In fact, you have to be, and I'll transgress here against my own policy to make my point, you have to be a racist to use the word race. if you don't believe that there are different races among humans, which is the scientific ironclad fact, then you can't use the word race. Okay. But that said, the president must be excused for using the word in the way that many social justice warriors use it. For example, if we criticize the aspects of the Islamic religion, which give us the Muslim problem, wherein Muslims don't just fight politically, they fight religiously and they kill people, we are called racists. It's not racist, as philosopher neuroscientist Sam Harris maintains, and as comedian and news pundit Bill Maher maintains. It's cultural. Okay? Islam's not a race. It's a religion. It's an ethnicity. Okay? Now, if you're going to allow social justice warriors the incorrect right to call Islam a race and to call questions which go against things they believe in racist, which is ridiculous, you have to afford Donald Trump the same right. I'm not defending Donald Trump. I'm saying you have to fight fairly. Okay, remember, I'm a philosopher, or I'm aiming to be a philosopher, or I'm aiming to be philosophical, which means I'm aiming at the truth. It's the only good way to fight a fight. It's the only way to win a fight and to look yourself in the mirror and have any self-respect. It's the only way to have any moral credibility in a fight. And so, I don't use the word race, but as long as social justice warriors, left-wingers, and Democrats use the word race, they have to allow Republicans to use the word race. So here's what the president did. When this journalist from CNN asked him if he thought that his pronouncements had been emboldening the political agenda of white supremacists, a completely fair question, which I stand behind, he thought it was a divisive question, which was going to divide up white people and black people. Now hold on to your seats, strap yourself in, because I know that the current popular meme is that he's divisive. I'm not making that argument now, and I'm not arguing against it. But as long as you're willing to make it about group A, you have to be willing to accept that it may be levied against you from group A to group B, you and me. Okay, so he thought that was a divisive question. He thought that that was unfairly painting him out to be an ethnophobe. That's the correct word. For those who don't understand, he thought that was racist. So he called it a racist question. We all know Donald Trump gets tongue-tied. We all know he has a limited vocabulary. We all know he's old and unqualified. We all know he's just a businessman from the bottom rung of business in human history, real estate. So we don't expect him, or we shouldn't, to have a very high level of self-control, decorum, statesmanship, and oratory, nor a great vocabulary. He meant to say that that's race baiting. But he doesn't have that word in his ready access memory. It's not in his short-term memory. He's a simple guy who says things like very good, very bad, beautiful, ugly, good person, bad person. What I'm trying to do here is to get left-wing people with whom I'm allied to think more and to be honest more once they have thought. I'm well aware that people like Wolf Blitzer and others who mean well haven't even considered the fact that Donald Trump has a limited vocabulary, he's old, he's unqualified. Well, they may have considered that. And so he's not going to be able to argue in a very highly intellectual way, as, say, an Obama can.